the brand new FP10 from Roland. So I am here with Remy from Roland, and we are checking out the brand new entry-level FP10.
Indeed.
So we've got the FP30 here as well. What's going on? Why have we got them both out? And what is this beast all about?
Okay, so before the FP10 was announced yesterday, I think, the FP30 was our entry level.
Yeah.
So this is where the FP10 has come in, just below the FP30. So I thought it'd be good to kind of compare the two.
Yeah, I'd say so. So what? Tell me about it. What is it? What's going on?
So it's a portable, as you say, entry-level piano.
Yeah.
It can come in like the one piece, get it on an X stand, or it does come with a stand as well if you want to. There's that option. So you've got a great feel, great sound. It's just basically a great value product, but I would say that, obviously. Try it for yourself.
Yeah, it sounds great. So it is I think we were saying earlier, it's the same sound engine as the 30?
Yeah, so same sound engine, actual same feel as well.
Yeah,
It feels good. Yeah, it's a really nice kind of weighting of the keys and the feel of the keys, because they're ivory, are nice as well. So they're individually weighted, so yeah, obviously heavy towards the bottom and light towards the top, but each and every key has their own individual weight, which basically just makes it as similar to an acoustic as possible. Arguably the best weighting at this price point.
Yeah.
So yeah, so it's the same sound engine as the FP30, Supernatural sound engine, which basically means that it's really expressive, you've got a great dynamic range, you've got keys that interact with each other, so when you press harmonically related keys, they're all combining the sound together.
That's
whereas
cool.
In like a purely sampled sound engine, you get two separate sounds played together, which isn't obviously how an acoustic works.
Yeah, that's cool. And in terms of sounds, how many have we got? What's going on?
So you've got 15 sounds, including four different piano sounds. And then the FP30 has 35, so you've got a 20 sound difference between the two.
Okay, nice.
But for nice and simple sounds, FP10 does that and more.
So this is the first.
Yeah, that'll be the
first. And then I assume
piano.
It's the same as the other one, you just hold the function.
Yeah.
Smack a button.
Yeah, and for those of you that obviously can't see, it actually says the sounds across the front panel here, so you can actually see which sounds you're selecting too.
Nice.
And then it's super simple as well to combine two sounds as well. So if you hold down function and then two sounds at the same time, so if you want strings and piano.
Where are strings, piano?
Yeah, that should. And then a really nice one as well is pad and piano, if you try that.
Function, pad, piano. That's nice.
Yeah.
There's quite a lot going on then for an entry.
Yeah.
There's a lot of features, a lot of good stuff happening.
Yeah, definitely. So you've still got like metronome built in, so great for people who are learning. It comes with obviously a sustain pedal as well. So it's a really great, like I say, entry-level piano. Does the job, great sound, great feel.
And most importantly, you have the jazz scat.
Oh, of course.
On every piano.
Yeah.
It's always there.
I know.
And this Bluetooth, you can connect this up your famous piano partner.
You can indeed. Connect it to piano partner, control it all through there. You get sheet music as well, so you can play along to favourite songs. What else? Flashcards, learning stuff, and recording as well. So the FP10, you can't actually record into the instrument. You have to do it through piano partner.
Which you can on the 30.
You can on the 30, which makes it a lot easier if you are, you know, maybe practicing one hand and then the other hand and putting the two together. Mm. Recording's really simple on this, but you know, it's just as easy to whack out your phone or your tablet to.
Yeah, to be I actually prefer recording using apps.
It's really easy.
It's a lot easier to, because obviously there's no screen with this.
Yeah.
So with that, I like screens.
Sure. So and with the 30 works as well, you can record into a USB, which you can use on your computer, whereas you can't do that with the FP10.
No? What's going on at the back?
There is a USB port, but that'll be for like updates.
Data storage, that thing?
Bluetooth, not Bluetooth MIDI, but MIDI through.
Yeah.
A to B.
Sweet, I'm into it, I like it a lot. So we mentioned earlier that they have the same sound engine.
Yes.
So technically they sound the same?
Technically through headphones, they'll sound the same.
Meaning speakers are different?
Yeah, so the speakers on the FP30 are a lot better. So you get a more rich sound with the FP30, and it also goes quite a bit louder as well.
Yeah.
You won't be able to hear the difference on camera, but if you are in store, definitely compare the sound on them.
Okay, cool. And other differences?
Other differences? So obviously, as we mentioned with the recording, so with this one you can record onto USB and through here, whereas this is just on the app. Another big difference is that with the FP30, you can get it obviously with the stand, but you can also get it with the 3 pedal board as well.
Okay.
Whereas with the FP10, you've only got
sustain.
So for people doing grades, the FP30 would probably be worth spending a little bit more on it so that you get the 3 pedal unit and you don't have to worry about upgrading when you get to a certain point. But
okay, so looking at who these are for, I mean, if you're like, if you just want a, you know, weighted keys, electric piano, you're starting out, FP10, banging.
Exactly. Brilliant for beginners.
But if you're kind of then a little bit beyond that.
Yeah, it's kind of like if you're already like having lessons, you kind of already know that you want to keep it up. FP10's really for those people who are just, you know, when you're just starting, it's really important to still have a really good instrument. And that's where the FP10 comes in, because it's still brilliant.
I remember, when I started, when I was 12, I started learning on a, you know, they weren't weighted keys.
Yeah,
and, you know, it was a little keyboard from like Argos or something.
Yeah.
I agree with you. I think having a great instrument like the FP10 is banging.
For sure.
So another feature that I read about or I saw, which I don't really know what it is, but is twin piano.
Yeah.
Tell me about twin piano.
Okay, so on both pianos, you couldn't split the piano in half. So you've got like half the piano here and then another piano there.
So two pianos.
Two pianos.
In one piano.
In one piano. So great for lessons.
Oh, okay.
Which is really cool.
Okay, got you. So if you had a teacher.
Yeah. And that's another thing as well.
Cool.
With the FP10, you've only got one headphone thing.
Yeah.
Whereas with the FP30, you've got two. So if you've got two people playing at night and you want to have two sets of headphones. Mm-hmm. The FP30 can do that, but the FP10 can't. Mm-hmm. Really small thing, but.
So how do we split the piano?
So hold function down.
Hold the function.
And then this one.
Okay, so it's literally down the middle.
Yeah, that one's mine.
Okay, cool, that's cool.
Yeah.
I like it. Useful function.
Cool, and then another thing worth noting is you can change the key weighting as well. So this is obviously on medium at the moment, but you can make them lighter or heavier. Five different options.
Boom. So a massive thank you to Remy from Ryland for showing me the brand new FP10. What do you think? Let us know in the comments box below. And if you want to see any more videos just like this one, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And we shall see you very soon.